Hello, I am Dr. Nagaraj Putswami. I am a laparoscopic surgeon at Punya Hospitals, Bangalore. Appendicitis. Appendix is an organ which is located in between the small intestine and the large intestine. The appendix is a vestigial organ in humans, but it is important because it contains some amount of lymphoid follicles. I mean to say that it contains a lot of lymphocytes in that submucosal layer, so that it easily catches up infection far quicker than any other organ in the intestinal system. See, we find a condition called catarrhal appendicitis. Catarrhal is something like what we call viral appendicitis. These conditions can easily be managed medically. The patient will present with pain in abdomen or fever-like thing, and we can still manage the patient by giving IV fluids and antibiotics and managing the patient with painkillers. But we have seen threatening problems where the patient doesn't respond to medical management, where we may have to intervene and try to manage the patient surgically. But common problems associated with appendicitis are the perforation of appendix, which leads on to a complicated scenario. And we found appendicular abscesses, we find appendicular mass. So these are the common complications associated to appendicitis. That is one important reason why we suggest appendix has to be removed at the earliest once it is infected. And as such, it doesn't serve a major important function during the process of digestion. So it can easily go out of the body without causing any physiological change. Okay, appendicitis. Appendicitis is infection or inflammation of the appendix. Appendix is an organ which is located in between the small intestine and then the large intestine. It's a vestigial organ. It doesn't serve any major important role and function during the process of digestion in human body. See, it can get infected just because it has high amount of lymphoid follicles in the submucosal layer. I mean to say that the follicles easily take up all the infection which can possibly happen in the intestine and succumb into the infection. But appendicitis can also happen during a process of a small fecolith obstructing the base of the appendix, or a blood vessel of the appendix getting blocked and causing gangrene of the appendix. These are common things what we find. Usually the appendix is seen in young adults, a teenager, about 15 to 20, 25 years of age. But we have seen patients very early, maybe 2 years of old, and I have seen a patient very old of 90 years also. But usually it is seen in younger age group. Patient usually presents with pain in abdomen, vomiting and fever. This is the cardinal symptoms of appendicitis. Usually the pain will be in the upper abdomen, gradually comes to the umbilical region and settles in the right lower abdomen. Patients presents in the early morning, has a possible diagnosis by afternoon, and 99% of the times lands up in a surgical procedure by evening. This is the process wherein the patient undergoes during the process of the day, because it is usually acute. How we diagnose appendicitis is by clinical evaluation of history and examination, and parallelly we try to do ultrasound scanning or a CT scan if required, if there is a dilemma, and basic blood investigations. Blood investigation will tell that total count of the WBCs will be significantly high, suggesting that there is an active infection which is happening. Most of the time, it is the surgeon's decision which will be more important, because it is evaluated more clinically and less by evidential diagnosis. Is appendicitis an emergency? If I have to answer this question, I am very much in favor of that, telling that it is mandatory an emergency surgical procedure. I am forced to tell this just because I have seen many and plenty number of complications related to appendicitis. I have seen patients being managed medically for appendicitis and landing up in a formation of a mass or abscess or perforation, and landing up in life-threatening complication called peritonitis and septic shock. Very recently I saw a small young boy of 8-year-old whose appendix was perforated, and he was treated. Finally, he landed up in septic shock and he straight away was admitted in ICU in a very critical scenario. Once he was operated, he was relatively better. So I don't want to the patient to go into that state and then get the surgical work completed. So that's the only thing what I'm very, very particular about, trying to tell that any appendicitis is to be considered as a surgical emergency and to be operated. Even if the patient is presented in the OPD late in the evening, say around 7 or 8 in the night, we still try to observe him, analyze him, diagnose. If it is appendicitis, I prefer to operate in the night itself instead of leaving him to the next day morning and possibly have a complicated appendix by morning. So in this view, I always consider and tell that appendicitis is a surgical emergency and it has to be addressed at the earliest to avoid major life-threatening complications. Appendicitis is a condition which is a surgical emergency. It has to be treated surgically only. We as a surgical resident or a registrar or a surgical student have learnt appendectomy getting performed conventionally by open methods. But as it is evolving and we have grown and we have become mature, I've seen laparoscopic appendectomy being the perfect choice for managing acute appendicitis. See, it's not that we cannot operate conventionally. We can comfortably operate conventionally, which all our seniors and my teachers have done successfully. But laparoscopic appendectomy has a significantly higher advantage over open appendectomy. Laparoscopic appendectomy is performed with only three instruments or three ports, what we call. We usually put a telescopic port in the umbilical region and two other ports which are used as operating instruments, all of them being 5 millimeter each. And finally, identify the location of the appendix, seriousness of the condition. We try to disconnect the appendix from the cecum and retrieve it out of the abdominal cavity. Depending upon the spillage of a toxic material which has already happened or the exudate which has happened, we try to lavage that area. That is, I mean to say that clean the area with the help of normal saline or medicated solutions, whichever is required on the operating field. We have all the possible options. Say for example, the appendix is abnormally located in the retrocecal region, but still it is badly infected. We can comfortably operate on those patients laparoscopically compared to open surgery, and usually mobilize the large intestine and retrieve the appendix comfortably. And if required, a drain has to be left drain out whatever the toxic material, which can still happen following surgery. That also is a possibility through laparoscopy. Highest advantages of laparoscopic surgery is hardly any scar left on the abdominal wall. Very quick recovery. Maybe today we operate, patient is out of the hospital tomorrow morning, and maybe day after tomorrow patient start working. And very little possibility of wound infection and post-operative hernia possibilities. All these are huge advantages related to any laparoscopic surgical procedure. So I always rate laparoscopic appendectomy surgery as a much higher advantage when compared to open appendectomy.